Honorable Sri Deepak Mishra ji, it is of India, Dr. Harshvardhan ji, Senior Minister of the Government of India, Swatantra Kumar, Chairman, National Green Tribunal, Justice Antonio Herman Benjamin, and the K.K. Venugopal ji, Padraji General, Diamante Singh, Supreme Court Judges, Chief Justice of all different high courts, judges and distinguished international and national dignitaries who have come from different parts of the globe. Guests, my dear students and brothers and sisters, it gives me great pleasure to be part of this project gathering. I must take this opportunity to appreciate the efforts of the National Green Tribunal in successfully organizing such events along with collaborating with others in the past at international and national levels. And for the present event also, World Conference on Environment 2017. These events serve as forums for discussion on wide-ranging environmental issues of universal concern. This is the second international conference on the subject I have told this year, and the fourth international conference on environment being organized under the aegis of NGT. Brothers and sisters, we have had decades of deliberations on international environmental consciousness, jurisprudence and laws. We have progressed from denial to acceptance of global warming. We have moved from non-voluntary and non-mandatory contributions to voluntary commitments to mitigate the threat of climate change. Many countries have started taking proactive measures for protecting the environment. We are also realizing a little slowly, of course, a little painfully, that we have been recklessly damaging our environment. Wisdom is slowly drawing upon all countries that our existence is at stake, and we have to act fast to avoid catastrophe. I remember my younger days when I used to go from my native place to my mother's place, and from mother's place to my grandmother's place. This was only 2 kilometers from each other. Elders used to warn us not to travel in the afternoon. I used to ask them why. Because it's a thick forest and there will be thieves and other things also. I wonder if I have in front of me today, if I travel from my village to my mother's place to my grandmother's place, there is not even a major tree visible anywhere. Forget about the forest. But then the situation we have successfully destroyed forest. This is not the case with India alone, the case with many of the other countries also. At this point, I am reminded the words of Mahatma Gandhi. He stated, just now the Chief Justice also mentioned, the earth, the air, the land, and the water are not inheritance from our forefathers, but are loaned from our children. So we have to hand over them at least as it was handed over to us. So we have to improve upon that also. These times call for collective intervention by the international community for pushing the environmental agenda and working on it. Meticulously charted sustainable development path of keeping global warming well below 2 degrees. We are now in the present regime of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. But LPG and SDG, they must go together. This liberalization, privatization, globalization, and sustainable development goals, LPG and SDG, they must move hand in hand. Economic growth should not be seen as independent of environment. What nations need to work together for is sustainable economic growth. Many countries around the world call our planet the mother earth. Many religions have given us a rich heritage of thoughts and ideas on living harmoniously with nature. In India too, we have a rich repertory of hymns and practices that celebrate, worship and preserve nature. For instance, Bhusuktam in Atharvada Veda, written almost 20 centuries ago, celebrates nature and seeks to see it protected and preserved. O Mother Earth, may your hills and snow-clad mountains spread their coolness. May your forests spread delight on your foundation, which is unconquered, unstayed, and unbroken, and stand firm. This is said 20 years ago. Destruction of trees frowned upon, and Prophet Muhammad well springs of our collective heritage need to be revived. We must not only recollect some of the best thoughts from our past, but also shape our present in line with those noble ideas. Or else, our future might turn to be dark and bleak. The signs of a catastrophic future are already actually here for us to experience. We do not have clean air and clean water in many cities. Our quality of life is constantly declining. GDP is important, but at the same time, as I told you, it's even more important to improve human lives. Quality of life is the ultimate test of all our development efforts. Development has very little meaning if it does not lead to a healthy happiness and harmony. Having served the government for some time, I have often confronted this question of what takes priority, environment protection or development. It's often debated. I can say confidently that there is no intrinsic contradiction between the two. All that is needed is to check over exploitation. As Gandhiji has said, nature provides enough to meet our needs, but cannot provide for our greed. The challenge is huge. However, if you have the political will, the administrative skill, we can achieve results. Each wing of our polity has a distinct role to play. The legislature frames laws that address the concerns of the people. The executive effectively implements and delivers. The judiciary ensures that these laws are interpreted and implemented both in letter and spirit. I do hope each one of us, each of these cases of responsibility acting in his job with a common objective but within the clearly defined parameters designated by the Constitution. The environmental change is occurring at a much faster rate than previously thought. These threats are populate growth. We are unmindful of it. Rapid urbanization. People are moving from rural to urban. Even I have moved from rural development to urban development in the government. People are moving for better living. Are they really having better living? That has to be thought of. Education, employment, entertainment, economic accomplishment, and enhancement of the city. These are the five needs that are driving the people from rural area to urban area. And recently we had a new concept of smart cities. What is smart city? We discussed the right to declaring international level also consultation and all. Finally, I came to the conclusion. Smart city means city where people can live happily. Happily. Happiness includes wellness. Otherwise, simply getting an extension is a pension. Getting extension without listening, attention, will further increase that. So, friends, we have to take care of our population. Take an unpopular remedy, anybody speaking about population in sector, within sector, they have been letting it down. We are now trying to forcefully tell people that forcefully control the population. I am not saying that. People have to understand, because the same land, same water, water levels can also decrease. And then the population is increasing. By the time we start the meeting and then we close the meeting, there is further growth also. Rapid urbanization, rising levels of consumption, desertification, land degradation, and climate change have combined to leave countries suffering from severe water scarcity. Some people warn, if we go by this way, there will be water wars also. We have to preserve water, rainwater harvesting, water recycling, better utilization of optimal utilization of water in proper manner. All these things have to be thought of in the population. And people have to be educated. These highly disturbing trends are also making it increasingly hard for the world to feed itself. To speak of Asia Pacific region, the rapid and much desired economic growth has left a very huge impact on the natural resources and ecosystems. Worsening air quality, extreme water scarcity, and hazardous waste generation are threatening human and environmental health. We have seen in Delhi earlier they experimented alternative to not have better air alternative. Because without air, we don't have any source of air. you have to think about that. If he is having 1 lakh crore vehicle, 1 crore vehicle, because you have not focused enough attention on public transport. Everybody is purchasing a car, son, daughter, mother, brother, brother-in-law, son-in-law, all the cars. Everybody is having a car. When cars are coming, what about the road? They face it the same. So that's why as a minister, I used to travel by metro from airport to residence. Metro is no tenter. Only a tenter. I can go. So the public transport, encouraging public transport, formulating laws and regulations for encouraging public transport are need of the hour. We can't leave it like this. The region continues to be the world's most disaster-prone region, having 41% share of all natural disasters reported over the 2 decades, which also accounted for 91% of the world. This is very alarming. In Southeast Asia, the average area deforested annually is more than 1 million hectares, resulting in the release of hundreds of millions of tons of carbon dioxide every year between 2005 and 2000. So the contamination of water sources by human and industrial waste, including pharmaceutical and personal care products, is a major problem in the region. It is estimated that about 30% of the population uses contaminated drinking water, water-related diseases, and unsafe water contribute to 1.8 million deaths. We are thinking that we are taking care of water by having mineral water. The people of the country, are they in a position to afford mineral water? That also is a question that we have to address. We need the political class of the country. The rulers and the people who are breaking the law, they have to seriously think about all these things. Uncontrolled dumping, which is still the main waste disposal method in the region, is also a major source of disease. In Mumbai, for example, about 12% burned either openly on the streets or in landfills. Rapid economic growth and intensified industrialization has also led to increasingly unhealthy, polluting and carbon-intensive lifestyle. Global warming is not merely a concern due to increased temperatures. It is displacing people out of their homes, where their ancestors and forefathers have dwelt for centuries in such a livelihood, put the shelter due to altered geographic and climatic conditions. According to WHO, World Health Organization, approximately 12.6 million deaths are attributable. Out of this, 8.2 million deaths have resulted from non-communicable diseases like cancer, strokes, heart problems, chronic respiratory diseases, etc. Regionally, the low and middle income countries in Southeast Asia and Western Pacific region are the worst people. Distinguished speakers and audience, I would like to all of you, all of us, to reflect on certain key issues and seek solutions to our current predicament. Is it time for the world to formally adopt a country way of measuring growth, which is more holistic and reveals a true picture of progress and quality of life and not merely economic growth? Economic growth of undoubtedly is required, and we are now in an aspirational India, but the aspirations are very high. Can we move beyond the boundaries of countries and adopt a regime of global streets and world governance in matters which are great concern to the entire humanity? It is time to move towards an ecocentric approach where the role of human race is not merely that of stewardship, but that of health. Can we discover, invent, and innovate methods to maintain economic growth and bring holistic prosperity without adverse impact on the environment? We must find answers to these questions and also think about the need for population control. We should also involve the people. We should not leave everything to the government. Because over the years, we people entering this part of the region, we learned the habit that everything will be done by the government. So, come, Sarkar Karega, Ambekar Vadeti Karega. We throw our dust in the neighbor's house and he throws his dust in our house. Equally. We have to really think about it. That's why I